Hello everyone and Happy New Year. I am Stephanie, an artist living in Vannes, France. 2021 is upon us and I wish you all a very healthy year. Also, it'd be really nice to not have a year straight out of a science fiction book this time around. So if it could get just a little bit boring and very average, that would be real nice. Now in today's video, I am showing you my first sculpture of 2021. Technically, I started it last year, but I mean, who's counting, right? Now, of course, I forgot to record the part where I am actually carving the book, so you just have to imagine that. I mean, it wasn't anything really crazy. I simply glued four books together and then butchered them with a cutter, page after page, like the psycho I am, creating a sort of landscape. Now, it was really done on a whim, and usually when I get an idea, I get super excited and, you know, I just dive into it without any second thinking, any second thought. And of course, when you're in that state of mind, you usually can't be bothered with recording it, which explains the lack of video footage for that part. So I'm really sorry. Next time I will try to record from the beginning to the end, because that makes more sense for video anyway. Honestly, with this sculpture, I didn't really know where I was going with it at first. I just wanted to carve a sort of landscape in a book. Now, I ended up using four books because they were actually very thin and it would not have been a good look with just one of them. I ended up really enjoying carving the book out. Working with books make me really appreciate working with paper as a sculpting material, and that is something I'm very excited about. You know my love for watercolors, and the possibility of adding paper and watercolor to my sculptural works is something I find exciting and interesting. Now, clay is nice, but sometimes it gets really tiring to use it, first in terms of toxicity, and sometimes just because of the technique, the drying time or the baking time, and then it might break or that one is not flexible enough and so on. Clay can be tricky to use. Working with paper is a lot less harmful in general, and also quite slow paced. You're not worried about drying time, the clay going bad or anything like that. And paper is actually very sturdy for its thickness, and it will resist shocks and bendings much more readily than clay, or at least most clays. Now, I have been implementing paper more and more in my works, but I really want to keep doing that and adding more and finding new techniques around paper and clay. Now, the more I sculpt, the more materials are added to my work, which can feel a little overwhelming at times, but after some years of practice, I have developed a better understanding on which materials to use for which applications. In fact, I've also started to work on a bigger Skillshare class about all the sculpting materials I currently use, and it's going to be a massive one. Now, my goal and hope, let's say, it's more a hope than a goal really, is to get that class done by the end of January. That would be ideal. Now, I'm currently having or using four different clays in my working studio and two key materials. And people keep asking me about them, but there's just too much to say. I cannot explain everything I use in one or two sentences, so I decided to make a class about it. Truthfully, I've been on-off thinking and writing about that class for a couple of months now, but I've recently made a paper plan and recorded the whole process. Yay me, I didn't forget. Hence, I will be doing a class with small projects in it for each clay or material I'm going to showcase. So yeah, the class outline is starting to be well-defined, and I'm actually pretty excited to finally do that class. I really need to start writing everything down so I know what to record. This class is really going to be for beginners, but also for more advanced sculptors who are looking into mixed media sculptures. I know I would have loved a class like that a few years ago when I started to dive into more mixed media, because I mean, there are just so many materials out of there, so where to start? It really can get daunting. Honestly, Skillshare really has become my main source of income, and while I often do small project classes, as let's be honest, they're easier to make for myself, they're easy to record and edit. But once in a while, I know I have to tackle a more theoretical, a bigger class, as that's what is most useful to aspiring artists. So next to a few other goals, I really want to get this class done by the end of January. So yeah, let's hope I can manage. That being said, I'm currently full of energy, so I might actually manage to do that. I actually took almost 1 month of break, and I now realize how much I needed that break. Last year ended up being full of work opportunities for me, which was great, but it also meant going from one project into the other project without any real holidays or breaks. Now, you know, being an artist is always a bit weird, as sometimes nothing happens for months on end, sometimes years, and suddenly, out of nowhere, you've got all these galleries coming at once, and you can't quite say no, because that's what you've been working towards. But yeah, basically, I didn't take any holidays in one full year, which is a bad idea altogether. Don't do that. Make time for breaks. They are important for your mental health. But that month really did wonders. Now I feel refreshed and creative again. The last month of last year felt mostly like struggling all the time, and I think you've probably noticed in my videos. I think there was not one sculpture or artwork where I didn't say that I struggled with it. And yeah, probably because I was really tired at that time. But yeah, now I'm better, so it should be better from now on in this new, fresh year, so to speak. Incidentally, my mind now won't shut up about new ideas, and I have the energy to make them, so that's good. I will also try to not work on weekends this year. That's a huge goal for me, not work on weekends. I have been doing that more or less successfully the last month, but I really want to keep on doing that because I am extremely good at cramping my days with everything I want to do, which is mostly work. I just get easily excited when it comes to doing art, and then, you know, I also need to work for money, so it's really not an issue for me to work way too much. Work-life balance is an ongoing work in progress, but from what I gather, it's a common issue among most artists, so I don't feel too guilty about not having the perfect work balance. I think the key is really to know when to actually take a break. I think it's perfectly fine to push yourself physically, mentally, and creatively, but when you feel like everything is too much and you're on the verge of breaking, then yeah, just take a break, you know, take a rest. Nothing bad will happen. Nobody's going to die. Everything is going to be just fine. It's inevitable to go through these phases of very highs, high creativity, high ideas, you know, very high intensity workflow. And then these phases of lows where you just feel like sitting in a chair and doing nothing much all day, apart from eating cookies, maybe. But yeah, you need to understand how to function and how you personally function and where your breaking point is. But back to the book. This bookscape left me craving more bookscapes. You might know that I'm working towards a solo show for next year, and books will be the central focus of that solo show. So expect to see all sorts of crazy book sculptures coming to you until then. I've got a bunch of ideas and I need to make them to be able to create a coherence of some sort for that show, other than just, well, those sculptures are on books. A friend of mine actually keeps giving me books she wants to get rid of, which I'm weirdly very grateful for. She lived and worked in Japan for a year, so she gave me some interesting books that I need to find ways to use in a different way. I myself have also a bunch of books I wanted to get rid of, so those will come in handy as well. I think I probably have already too much books to work on, but that's good, honestly. It means I can make mistakes. On that note, the 4 books I used in today's sculpture are all about urbanism and architecture. You might know that I studied architecture, and so these books are from that era. I vaguely thought about making tiny buildings to stay on point with the books, but I have no interest in actually actually making tiny buildings. So yeah, that idea was extremely short-lived. Okay, that's really all there is to say for today's video. Again, I wish you a very healthy 2021. Thank you so much for watching. If you liked this video, please give it a thumbs up, comment, share, and consider subscribing. And I will see you in my next one. Bye!